Want to help kids get their homework done? Well, an internet connection is a good start. But kids also need computers. And sometimes the hardest thing about homework is finding a place to do it. So why not hook community centers up with Wi-Fi for kids like us and all the amazing things we're going to learn?
Over the next 10 years, Comcast is committing $1 billion to reach 50 million low-income Americans with the tools and resources they need to be ready for anything.
I hope you're ready, because we are.
Moms and dads, listen. You're not the problem, but you are part of the solution. And this podcast is here to help you reach with your troubled child. Known as the Teen Whisperer, Jason Clopton counsels young adults and has a proven track record of reaching kids when parents can't. Listen and take notes. This show will help you figure out what's bugging your baby and build a bridge to a better relationship with your kids.
Hello, and welcome to the Teen Whisperer podcast. My name is Anissa Keyes. I am actually filling in for Jason Clopton, who is the originator of the Teen Whisperer podcast. I'm a mental health professional and the president of Aruba Emotional Health Services, a local agency here in the Twin Cities. If you ever want to reach out to us, we're at www.arubaemotionalhealth.com. Aruba is spelled with an H. We have a link there where you can put in your contact information and we'll get right back to you to schedule something. Or you can always call our intake line at 612-284-8115. So we're doing this 3-week part series on how to raise healthy teens. I debunked 3 myths and then I shared 3 truths. I broke them into chunks, like on each podcast, because there's too much information to give you on one. So check out the previous podcast if you want to know. What we talked about was, number one, teaching your kid how to fail well. We also talked about teaching your child responsibility. That is an imperative character building trait. And then the third was how to let your children know that they are loved, but that is the most important thing, more important than positive self-esteem even. Today, our last day, my last day on the Teen Whisperer podcast. I know, I'm so sad to go, but Jason will be back soon and he is the real Teen Whisperer. I'm so grateful to have filled in the time that I did. And I was able to like reach so many people. So really excited that I had this opportunity to share. Okay, the last myth, the surprise myth and the truth. I know I said 3, but I figure since I got this one more week, I'll just add this nice one in here for you. This is one that's gonna set y'all free for real. Okay, now I know everybody has all kinds of ideas on how to raise healthy teens. So this idea that I'm telling you about, these are 3 myths, and here's an extra myth and an extra truth about how to raise healthy teens. Okay, I'm using some book knowledge, just so you guys know. I was educated as a mental health professional, but then additionally, I'm raising 4 teenagers, or I've raised 4 teenagers, right? And then most importantly, I've worked in a clinic with a lot of young people. And I've seen a lot of challenges that teens have had, and especially their parents have had managing their behaviors or just raising them in general. So this final myth, okay? The very final myth. You guys heard this one before. Make sure as parents, as coaches, as teachers, that we put the kids' needs above our own. Sacrifice, right? Like we hear this all the time. That's what we're talking about, like prioritizing the needs of your child over yours. It only makes sense. They didn't ask to be here, right? They are just here and they're our responsibility. So that means whatever they need, it comes first over us. Ensure that they get what they need even before we get what we need. Ensure that they're okay even before we find out or we make sure that we're okay. That sound familiar? I see it all the time. I have parents that come into the clinic getting support for their kiddos. They never have enough time to make it into therapy themselves. I see parents go without medical appointments, dental appointments, but their kids, they're on it for them, making sure that their baby gets everything they need. Can I tell you that that is a horrible myth? Putting the needs of your child before your own, is not helpful. As a matter of fact, it's harmful to you and your baby. The first time that I really tussled with this for myself as a parent, because I know we all do, right? It's our natural inclination. They're our babies, right? We give our last piece of food, chicken to them, right? We're like, no, you eat, you're good. Mama, get hers, she'll be okay. And your stomach's all growling and stuff, right? The first time I tussled with this was when I was on an airplane. I was headed out of town. At the time, I only had my daughter. And you know how they give you the little instructions and they're like, hey, make sure if something happens and the mask drop down, make sure you put the mask on yourself first and then you put it on your small children. Now, when I had my daughter with me, I was like, okay, because there's probably enough time for me to put my mask on and put my mask on my daughter. That's cool. But then after a few years, I was traveling with all four of my kids, right? And in my mind, I'm thinking there is no time for me to put my mask on and then get my mask on all of my babies, right? So somebody maybe wouldn't get their mask on in time, right? My kids would maybe, you know, stop breathing, right? Or, you know, start to struggle and distress, right? And I was like, no, I can't do it. Put my mask on my babies first. My babies come first. Nope, not gonna do it. Now I know some of your parents, I know some of the parents are feeling me on this, right? Because it's the natural response, right? The mama bear of like, no, I'm supposed to nurture and protect and take care of my baby. What kind of a mama would put their own mask on first? So it took me a while and some convincing and some practicing. But the truth is, parents, you need to put your needs above your children. That's a truth. Crazy, right? Yeah, some of you may have even stopped listening. You need to put your needs above your children. Check it out. The pilot is not telling you to put on yours first because he don't like your kids or he don't care nothing about your kids. If you think about it, he is saying you need to make sure you're good so your babies will be good, right? And we don't always translate that to like all of our areas of our life. But the truth is that if you're not good, no doubt your baby's not going to be good, period. No way around that. You can ensure that your baby is good all day, but your baby, your teenager, your child, they're regulated off of you. They need you to make sure that even if they're good for a day, that they remain good consistently and ongoing. So in order for your teen to be good, mama, you need to be okay. In order for your teen to be healthy, mama, daddy, coach, whoever, right? You need to be okay. Here's what I see at the clinic. I see a hurting mother trying to get her babies to a better place, but they can't support their babies being in a better place because they're struggling on their own. I see fathers not wanting their sons to make the same mistakes that they made, but not realizing because they haven't dealt with their own stuff, that they are inadvertently teaching their children the same things they were taught. I've seen children trying to get healthy, but their parents, who are the head of their lives, in charge of the house, in the mood in the house, the comings and goings of the people around the house, not doing anything different. So the kids can't do anything different. I know it seems backwards. What if I told you your kid's pain is really your pain? No, really. What if I told you that the most important element to them doing something different is you doing something different? What if I told you you working on yourself actually makes them better? Like not sending your kid to therapy, but you going to therapy. That putting yourself in a better position for success creates a higher likelihood of the entire family system getting better. Guess what? You only have time for one person to go. Guess who that should be? You. You only have money for one person to get a gym membership and get healthy. Guess who that should be? You. I get it. It sounds counterintuitive. It's kind of like how self-care sounds selfish, which is okay. It is, anyways. It's okay. Your biggest investment in your kids is actually investing in you. That's the truth. Now, I know you're not all going to believe it or change it. And maybe for some, it doesn't even make sense right now, right? And I say start small. The feelings of selfishness, they're going to be present. They're going to arise. But I promise you, your babies will be better for it. Maybe you're thinking there's not much time because they're teens and they're almost adults. And I know so many ways to rationalize and justify, because it's really hard to take your focus and your attention off of your teen and put it on you. So maybe you get someone to help hold you accountable. Get some people who are trying to also break this into you or create space for you to take care of you. I believe in you, and it is the best thing for your teen. Your health and your wellness will shift your whole world, and thus it will shift your teen's whole world. Now listen, if you have the ability to do both, best practices is both of y'all be in therapy, right? Best practices, both of you guys be seeking family support. Best practices is both of you be on a nutritional balanced diet, or both of you focus on healthy connection and working out, or whatever it is that you find the struggles are, right? Emotionally and physically, that are happening maybe with your teen. That is awesome. But oftentimes as parents, we don't have that much time. We don't have that much in resources. We don't have that much in money. And so oftentimes as parents, we tend to prioritize our children. Listen, do the opposite. Here's another disclaimer. Go shopping for you and not your babies. Or try doing something nice for you and not necessarily just your babies. We're talking about emotional, relational, behavioral issues in teens that oftentimes they start with you. Absolutely, 100% truth. The myth is sacrifice who you are, walk around here looking crazy, feeling crazy, try to make sure your babies are okay. Not gonna work. It's not gonna work. Okay, well, that's it, okay? That's our final myth, our final truth. The last time that I have with you guys, it was such a blessing to be here sitting in on behalf of Jason Clapton as we are praying that he returns quickly, because we know he has a wealth of wisdom and the originator of the Teen Whisperer, and knows how to speak to your babies in a whole nother different way. Remember, parents, okay? These were just four myths. These were four truths that you can cling on to. Remember, right, that you are not always the problem. Most of the times you're not, right? But you are always 100% of the time a part of the solution. All right. I'll see you later. Take care.
You've been listening to the Teen Whisperer podcast with Jason Clopton, known to his clients as JC the Counselor. Check back every Tuesday for new episodes wherever you listen to your podcasts. Find out more and connect with Jason at ShalettaMakesMeLaugh.com.
Listen, I know how hard it is for some of us to make this decision, but if you haven't been vaccinated yet, now is the time. This Omicron variant, y'all, it ain't no joke. The only way to protect you and your family is to get the vaccine. If you're on the fence and haven't yet, I understand. I didn't get the shot at first either, because as a Black woman, I just didn't trust the healthcare system. But I did it afraid, because I didn't want to get COVID-19 and die, then leave my four kids without their mama. So here's what I need you to do. Call your doctor or pharmacy and make an appointment to get the shot.
The state of Minnesota and Ramsey County have free clinics that offer the vaccine. You can find one near your house by going to their website at ramseycounty.us/COVID-vaccine. Or simply call 651-266-1190.
Do it for yourself. Do it for your family. Do it for your community.